Students, a very good morning. Myself is Sunish Chandan. I am dealing with the subject thermodynamics. In this subject, in unit 1, we are going to cover under first law of thermodynamics, the thermodynamic system, the properties of system, state and equilibrium, process and cycles, temperature, and the zeroth law of thermodynamics, heat and work transfer, first law of thermodynamics. That first law applied to the closed system, then its limitations. Energy property of the system, different forms of stored energy, the first law of thermodynamics for control volume, the steady state process, and examples. So this is the overview of the first unit, the first law of thermodynamics. And today's session, we are going to cover the thermodynamic system and the different types of systems. I am dealing with the different examples, so you can easily correlate the concept of the thermodynamic system our day-to-day life. Applications. Okay, so let's start. If you see this picture, that different applications before starting or before coming to the topic or what is my thermodynamics and their applications. Okay, just go through these pictures. If you see, there's a refrigerator, the piston environment, engine, gas turbine, or the satellite. Okay, so you can get an idea the wide area or the wide range of the application of the thermodynamics. Okay, we start from our home. Okay, when we deal with the refrigerator. Okay, so on which principle the refrigerator system works? What are the components? If you see, there is a backside, there is one coil. Okay, so what is called as a condenser? It dissipates heat. So what it means? If we compare with the IC engine, after some amount of time, the engine becomes hot. So what actually happening there? Okay, so in case of the gas turbine, what are the different processes going on? Combustion, compression, expansion, exhaust. So all are the process consist of the thermodynamics. There is a heat, there is a work, heat and work transformation. So just I used a word, two keywords are very important, the heat and work. So coming slides, you get an idea. So generally thermodynamics, when it going to define thermodynamics, it is the combination of two Greek words, is the therm and dynamics. The therm stands for heat and the dynamics stands for motion. Okay, so in that case, when you are going to combine, the heat energy is converted into some kind of work, some kind of energies, the either energy in the form of heat or either energy in the form of work. So first, let's start with the example. What is mean by system? Okay, so you can get an idea now what is mean by thermodynamics and then just different applications in previous slides you see. Now, there are the important terms when you deal with the different types of systems. The student should know what is mean by system, what is mean by surrounding, what is mean by boundary. Okay, if you see the picture here, a system, a particular area or a region where some thermodynamic activity takes place. So it is called as a system. Okay, just as shown here, a symbol, I just take a pen so we can easily shown here. So see here, in this symbolic I just drawn a system, but in actually if you see the piston cylinder arrangement here, this is a system, a particular area or region or a space where some thermodynamic activity is going on. Okay, in case of that piston cylinder arrangement, when I going to compress, okay, so what happened? There is a decrease in the volume, increase in the pressure, increase in the temperature. When I going to expand, there is an increase in volume, decrease in the pressure. Somewhat during compression, somewhat of heat is generated, the heat is lost to the surrounding. So some kind of thermodynamic activity is going on in forms of energy transformation, energy conversion. We generally know that the first law of thermodynamics or the law of conservation of energy. Okay, so where space, where some activity is going on, it's called as a system. Everything outside the system is called as a surrounding. And if you see here, the system and surrounding is separated by the surrounding boundary, okay, or the system boundary. Okay, so I again repeat, these terms are very important. Everything outside the system is called as a surrounding, and system and surrounding are separated by system boundary. Okay, these three terms are very important. Okay, so another concept regarding boundary, what is meant by real boundary and what is meant by the imaginary boundary? Okay, if you see this arrangement, okay, take an example of Western strain arrangement where I'm going to compress some gas. Okay, before compression, there is the gas accommodates some space inside the cylinder. Okay, that space is called as a real boundary. Now, after some interlock process, after expansion, the exhaust gas when leaks through that valve, okay, we can't trace that gas after exhaust where it sprayed. Such a case, that boundary is called as a convenient imaginary boundary. Okay, the boundary may be fixed or the boundary may be movable. Okay, if you see the previous example, this is the initial boundary. Okay, this is the now fixed boundary. When I'm going to compress or expand, that boundary may be variable. Okay, so that case, the boundary may be variable. Okay, so there are some terms: real boundary, imaginary boundary, fixed boundary, movable boundary. Now, this is very important parts. The thermodynamic system is classified in two groups mainly. The first, if you see the control mass system, second, the control volume system. Okay, why it is called control mass? Why it is called control volume? When you go deal with the different examples, okay, you can get an idea. In case of the control mass, if you see the closed system, isolated system, and deal with the control volume, this is an open system. Okay, now I'm going to define these three systems. Okay, and under that system, we're going to discuss the different examples. Then you get an idea of control mass and control volume. So first, let's start with the open system. Okay, if you see these two arrows as shown here, if you see red arrow, the exchange of energy with the surrounding, and the blue arrow indicates the exchange of matter with the surrounding. Okay, so if we trace out this figure, okay, if you read this figure, open system. When I define the open system, the system where the exchange of energy and the exchange of matter, which takes place and which crosses the boundary of the system. So the system in which energy as well as mass crosses the boundary of the system is called as an open system. Means in case of open system, where mass in, mass out, at the same time, some one form of energy in and another form of energies crosses the boundary of the system. So this system is called as an open system. In case of closed system, if you see, there is only one arrow, which is the energy transformation shows. In case there is no transformation of mass takes place, okay, there is only transformation of energy takes place, which is crosses the boundary of the system. So here, mass of the system is remains constant. There is only transformation of energy takes place. So one form of energy in and one form of energy is out. In case of isolated system, if you see here, no arrow shows. So what it indicates, there is no transformation of mass, there is no transformation of energy across the boundary of the system. The word I use particularly or specifically, across the boundary of the system. So see, across the boundary of the system means one form of energy enter, otherwise there is no chances of formation of another energy. It's again the law of conservation of energy. So transforming one form of energy to another form of energy, it's initially we have to transfer one form of energy. So in case of open system, in case of closed system, and in case of isolated, there is no transformation of energy takes place. Okay, so what amount of matter, on which state we stored, which is stored in the same state for a long period of a time. So these are the three systems which is classified under control mass. So under control mass, if you see isolated system and closed system, and under control value, there is open system. So coming slides, we can understood the what the meaning of control mass, what is the meaning of control value. So let's see with these examples. Okay, if you see this picture, okay, this is an example of closed system. Okay, if you see there's one pot here, I'm going to heat the water. Okay, what the case here, I have enclosed that pot pot with some plate. So what happened? There is a one form of energy enter in case of, suppose through burner we have to heat or to boil the water. So one form of energy in, okay, and via one form of energy loses or transfer its energy via conduction, via radiation through the surrounding. But the what amount of matter, that is mass of water, matter does not go in or out because we enclosed with the plate. Suppose there is evaporation takes place, but because of that plate, there is the no chances to mass will cross the boundary of the system. Such a case we call as a closed system. When we see that example, same evaporation of water or the boiling water takes place without plate, what happened? Some matter is transferred to the surrounding during evaporation. So it is called as a matter transformation. At the same time, one energy enter via burner, the thermal energy, one form of energy is loses or transfer via conduction, the heat energy to the surrounding. So it is the open system. And if you see this thermos flask, so you can now easily understood there is no exchange of energy and there is no exchange of matter takes place because it is the thermos flask. So what happened in thermos flask? It is the two glasses, okay, or this passage which is evacuated. So what happened? There is no medium to transfer its heat, okay. So what amount of state we stored? There's a hot tea or hot water, okay. So what happened? There is no any scope to rejection of heat to the surrounding because that two surrounding space or the two glasses are evacuated. So we create the vacuum there. So there is no transformation of energy takes place. So take the another example of closed system. Okay, if you see here, the gas enclosed in a piston cylinder arrangement. Okay, so what happened here? Initially, what amount of QM added? What happened? Now gas is going to expand. So we can get one kind of motion, expansion process, or that piston rod moves. Okay, so we can get one kind of motion. Suppose I want to regain its initial shape or initial position. What happened? I'm going to stop the heat. So what happened? The gas going to cool. Okay, and that piston takes again its initial position. Okay, so in that case, if you see carefully, the mass of the system remains constant. So only what happened? One form of energy in, suppose heat energy in, and what form of energy we get? The energy in the form of work, energy in the form of reciprocating motion. So heat energy in, work energy out, and it's vice versa. When I'm going to compress, so work energy I'm transforming or work energy entering the system. So what happened during compression? The gas is becomes compressed, is increasing its pressure, temperature, decreasing its volume. So Q is generated. So in that case, you can understood when I supply Q, I get W. When I supply W, I get Q. So what we conclude here? The heat and work are mutually convertible. Why I explain this concept now? Because when I discuss with the first law of thermodynamics, these terms or this concept we need that time. Okay, so hope students you understood what is meant by now actually what is meant by closed system, open system, and the isolated system. So the coming lecture or the next lecture, I will going to discuss with the different types of examples, and here we students should find out or justify why the system is closed, open, or isolated. So we meet in the next video where we discuss with the different types of examples. Thank you.